A very good morning, class 5. Class 5, yesterday we have started our new chapter, that is decimal fraction, and we have learned how to write the decimal in words, how to show it in place value, how to expand it, and what are the different types of decimal fractions. Today, let's start the next topic, that is comparison of decimal fractions. When we compare two decimal fractions, first we compare the whole number, part of the fraction. Okay, this is whole complete number 12.23. In this, whole number is there, 12. Before decimal, this is part of this number, this is whole number. After that, it is decimal place. Okay, so first we compare this. This is 12 and this is 14. So automatically we can say that 14 is greater than 12. So this number is greater than this number. Okay, but if there are same digit like 0 and after that 5 is here and 0 is here. First let's discuss this, okay? Obviously, the decimal fraction will the greater whole number is greater. Okay, whatever whole number is greater, that decimal fraction is greater. Now, in both the decimal fractions, if the whole number part is same or zero, means here zero is there, but maybe 12, 12 or 15, 15, whatever it can be, before the decimal, if that whole number is same, then how to compare? Then we compare the decimal fractions by their tenths place. Tenths place is, you know what? We have discussed yesterday, tenth place is just after the decimal place. This is tenth place. Okay? If they have the same digits in the tenth place, then we compare the hundredth place and so on. If tenth place is also same, like 5 and 5, then you have to compare with the hundredth place. This before decimal we read as ones, tenths, hundred, but after decimal we read as tenth, hundredth, thousandth, like this. Okay, yes. So 0.09 and here 0.58. so you know 5 is greater than 0. Here it is 0 and here in this, in the tenth place, it is 5. So 5 is 0, so we can easily say that 0.58 is greater than 0.09. Okay, now if questions ask you to arrange the decimal fraction in ascending order or in descending order, it may be. So what you have to do? First you have to compare the numbers. You should know how to compare the numbers, then only you will be able to write the numbers in ascending or descending order. Okay, see here. These are the numbers. And 0.38, 1.65, 0.048. So what we have learned, first we see the whole number. Whole number 0, 0 and 1. So this is greater. After that, less than that, we'll compare the 10th place. Here 3 and here 0. Then this number is greater and the smallest number is this one. So we have to arrange it in ascending order. When we arrange it in ascending order, first we write the smallest number, then greater than that, and after that the greatest number. And you have to give symbol like this. If question asks you to arrange in ascending order, so first you write the smallest number, then greater than that number, at last the greatest number, and you have to give the symbol of greater than. Here, if we write here, this is smaller than. 0.048 is smaller than 0.38, and 0.38 is smaller than 1.65. Like this, you have to show the numbers in ascending order. Okay, now, conversion of a decimal number into a common fraction. Yes, to convert a decimal fraction into a common fraction. To change a decimal fraction into a common fraction, first remove the decimal point. So what is the utmost work? You have to remove this decimal. How to remove? I have told you, for removing the decimal, यू हैव टू राइट बाय एंड यू हैव टू गिव द डिनोमिनेटर. सपोज दिस इज 2.04, द क्वेश्चन इज 2.04, सो यू हैव टू फर्स्ट रिमूव द डेसिमल. हाउ टू रिमूव द डेसिमल? 204, देन इन द डिनोमिनेटर प्लेस यू हैव टू राइट 1, एंड आफ्टर द डेसिमल वॉट एवर नंबर इज, हाउ मेनी डिजिट्स आर हियर, 10th एंड 100, टू डिजिट्स, सो यू हैव टू पुट टू जीरोज. लाइक दिस यू हैव टू चेंज इट इन टू फ्रैक्शन. ओके, नाउ बिकम्स द नंबर दस ऑप्टेन बिकम्स द न्यूमरेटर हुज डिनोमिनेटर इज 10, 100 और 1000 एज पर द प्लेस वैल्यू ऑफ द डेसिमल्स. मीन्स वॉट एवर नंबर इज आफ्टर द डेसिमल्स, वॉट एवर डिजिट्स आर देयर, द नंबर ऑफ डिजिट्स दैट वुड कम इन द डिनोमिनेटर प्लेस. 100 हियर, 1000 बिकॉज 3 डिजिट्स आर देयर आफ्टर द डेसिमल, हियर ऑल्सो 1000. नाउ इन टू एक्सप्रेस दिस दिस एंड दिस इन टू कॉमन फ्रैक्शन इन द लोवेस्ट टर्म. नाउ द क्वेश्चन आस्क यू टू शो इट दिस इन टू द lowest form. So in fraction you have learned how to show the number into its lowest form by cutting or by dividing the numerator and denominator both with a common number. Here 2.04, so first you have to convert this 2.04 into fraction by removing the decimal. So when you remove this decimal, this will become 204. Now divided by, as you have removed the decimal, you have to write the denominator. So denominator will be 100, two zeros, because there are two digits after decimal. This I have told you how to do. Now we have to express this into lowest form. So you have to divide the numerator and denominator both with the same table or same number. Which number you have to cut it? Suppose I am taking here table 4. 4 5s are 20, 4 1s are 4. Now 4 2s are 8 and 4 5s are 20. This is the lowest form. Now 51 by 25, these both numbers are not divided by a common number. So we have to leave it like this. But we have to change this fraction into mixed fraction. For converting that, you have to divide this. Okay, like as I have taught you to divide in the fraction chapter, fraction 51 by 25. So you have to divide 51 by 25. 25 2s are 50. So this 2 is whole number and this is remainder. So 2 whole 1 by 25. Right? So like this you have to show it. Now all you have shown. Now alternatively, how the next, what is the next method which you can apply? Either you can do like this or you can take, choose this option 2. Now after 2, write plus, means you have to expand it. Expanded form you have learned, so you have to expand this 2. Now plus 4, this 4 is in which place? 100th place after decimal, 10th, 100th. So 4 by 100. Now leave this 2 as it is. Now bring this to the lowest form. 4 1s are 4, 4 25s are, so 1 by 25. Now simply arrange it as it is, 2 whole 1 by 25. This is easy pattern than this one. You can opt any of this. Now conversion of a common fraction into a decimal fraction. Here it was decimal fraction, we have converted into common fraction. Now there is common fraction, you have to convert into decimal fraction. Now how to do? See, this is 3 by 8. Okay, 3 by 8. To change a common fraction into a decimal fraction, first we change the given common fraction into an equivalent common fraction whose denominator is 10 or a multiple of 10. After that we can change it into a decimal form. So what you have to look, you have to see if the, you have to first look at the denominator. Here denominator is 8, so how we multiply the denominator with which number so that the denominator comes as multiple of 10. If you multiply this by 125, the multiple has come of 10, that is 1000. So with the same number you have to multiply the numerator also. Now we got 375 by 1000. Now you can easily change this into decimal fraction. How? Three zeros are there, so you have to put decimal before three digits here. 1, 2, 3, and you have to put a decimal. Now this common fraction changed into decimal fraction. Look here also. 23 by 4. Now if we multiply by 4 by any of the number, we have to take care that whatever number we are choosing, the denominator will come as multiple of 10. So I have chosen, the question is itself, in example it is given by 25, 4 multiplied 25 is 100, so we have to multiply the numerator also with the same number, 575. Now change it into decimal. 1, 2. So 1, 2, put a decimal before two digits. So now this is in the form of decimal fraction from common fraction. Now we can also adopt the following division method to change a common fraction into a decimal fraction. Use the following steps. We divide the numerator by the denominator. When a non-zero remainder is left, we insert a decimal point in the dividend and the quotient and put a zero on the right of the decimal point in the dividend and the remainder divide again. We continue the division process just as in the case of whole number till the remainder is zero. So what you can do? 3 is here and denominator is 8. So you have to divide the numerator from denominator. How you can divide? 3 after putting decimal. When you put decimal, it means you can now take 1 0. So you have taken now 1 0. Now 8 threes are 24. Subtract. 6 is here. As you have put decimal here, so you can now put here 1 more 0. This becomes 60. Now again divide. 8 sevens are 56. Here remainder comes 4. Decimal, when you put decimal in the question place when while dividing, this decimal gives you permission to put 0. Okay, as there is no 0 in 3, but as we have put this decimal, now we have the right, or we got a permission sort of, to put 0 here. We have put 0. Now you have to take 0 until the remainder comes 0. Last 0 you have taken, then 8 5s are 40. This is completely divided. Now 3 by 8 is equal to 0.375. Understood? Same you can do for this also. See, 23 divide by 4, numerator by denominator, 23 you have written. 4 5s are 20, write here 3. 4 5s are 20. This 23 is more than 4, so we can easily divide this 23. Whatever number comes less than 23 in the table of 4, so we have divided 4 5s are 20. Till here we are not required to take any decimal. But now 3 is remainder, but 3 can't be divided by 4, so you have taken here decimal. Decimal means permitted to take 1 0. Now 4 7s are 28, again 2. As you have put the decimal here, again you are permitted to put 1 0. 4 5s are 20, the remainder is 0. So now 23 by 4 fraction, we can show it like this also, 5.75. understood? Either you take this way or this way. This is the more appropriate method, so that there will be no mistake. In this you have to keep on dividing and get the answer how the multiple of 10 comes. But this is very easy, okay, for conversion of decimal fraction into common fraction. You can choose this option as this is more convenient, and for the conversion of common to decimal you can choose this division sort of. Okay, now rounding off decimals. How to round off the decimals? Rounding off to the nearest ones. As we rounded off the numbers to the nearest tens, hundreds, thousand, are you remembering? Like sometimes the question asked us, round off the given number to the nearest tens. If 36 is given, so I have taught you 36 comes between 30 and 40, but when there is more than 5 in the tens place or ones place, whatever question asked, so this is more than ones, so we are rounding off it to 40. Now in the same way, come here. We have to round off. Round off the decimal fraction to the nearest ones, tenths, hundredths and so on. In common, normal number, common number, we use tenths, hundredths, thousand. But for fraction, we have to choose ones, tenths, hundredths and so on. This method is the same as we discussed above. For rounding off to the ones, we see the digits in the tenths place. If it is less than 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, the digits in the, we will round off the digits in the one place remains the same. And the digit in the tenths place is replaced by 0. If the digit is in the tenths place is more than 5, that is 5, 6, 7, 8, we add 1 to the digit in the ones place and replace the digit in the tenth place by 0. Okay, let me show you. Round off 9.6 to the nearest ones. Okay, now you have to change this into ones. So you have to remove the decimal also. Means you have to now take this out into a whole number. 9.6. How to round off this 9.6 into a whole number? As we were rounding off to the tens place, like 9. When we were rounding off 9, we are taking it to the tenth place, 0 or 10. It comes between 0 to 10. So we are rounding off this 9 to the tenth place. But when decimal is given, 9.6, now you have to look after the decimal place, what is there in the tenth place. Okay, this is 6. This is more than 5, so you have to put here 0 and you have to add here 1. So this will become 10. So 9.6 is equal to 10. Now if questions give that 9.4, now this is less than 5. If more than 5, you will simply put 1 0 here and you have to add 1 here. Whatever number here it would be, you have to add 1 to that number simply. Now, but if it is less than 4, then you have to put here 0 and the number will be same as it is. Understood? See here, 9.6 to the nearest ones, so 10.0 or 10. Rounding off to the nearest tenth. See the digit in the hundredths place. If it is 5 or more than 5, adding 1 to the tenth place digit and replace the digit in the hundredth by 0. See here, 9.76. Now if after decimal it is given and the question is telling you to round off, you will see this 100th place. As I told you for others also, now you see the 100th place. When we were rounding off in the 10th, we are seeing the 1's place. When 100, we are looking at the 10th place. Here just opposite. You have to change the 1, so you have to look at the 10th place. This is 6, means this 6 is more than 5. You have to put 0 here and you have to do plus 1 in the 10th place. As the questions asking you to round off the nearest 10th, means this place just after the decimal. In this question asks you to round off to the nearest ones. Nearest ones means before the decimal. That's why you have rounded off to 10, 9.6. So this 6 is more than 5, we have put 1 0 here and plus 1 in the ones place. But now question asks you to round off to the nearest tenth, means tenth place, this one. I told you after decimal directly tenth come. So you have to now convert it into tenth, so you look for the hundredth place. In hundred, here it is 6. So more than 5, you put 1 0 here and add 1 here. 9.80 or 9.8, as 6 is greater than 5. 15.72, this 2 is less than 5, so you will put 1 0 here and the 10th place will be same it is. Now see here also, 2 and 5, this 5 is more than 6, so you put 0 here and 1 carry here, so 108.30. now if the question asks you to round off to the nearest hundredth. Now if you have to round it to the hundredth, you have to look for the thousandth place. Okay, 6, look at the thousandth place. 7 is more than 5, so you have to put 1 0 here and you have to put plus 1, so 9.57. so this will come as 0 and here 1, so you have to remove this. Now 54.485. So 5 is more than or equal to 5. So 0. When you put 0 means here you don't have to write anything. This is vacant. Okay, you have to remove that place. Now simply you have to plus 1 here. So you have added it. Again 8 is more than 5. So 0, no value, plus 1. 2. Same way 2. 2 is less than 5. So we will write the number is this. Now same as 3 is greater than 3 is less than 5. Just remove this place and the number will be as same it is before that 100th. Understood? Now rounding off decimal fraction to the nearest whole number. How to round off the decimal fraction into the nearest whole number, not fraction, whole number. How to convert? Look at a digit in the 10th place. 10th means immediately after the decimal. This is 4, so this is less than 5. So you have to convert the number, you have to take all zeros this side. Whenever number is less than 5, see here, this is less than 5, where? This is 2. This 2 is less than 5, so simply we have removed it and the same number in the 10th place will as it is. Here also, when it was less than 5, simply remove that and keep this place vacant and write the number as it is. Same you have to do when you convert the decimal fraction into nearest whole number. What do you have to do? If the 10th place is less than 5, remove all the numbers after decimal. Simply write the number same it is as it is in the whole number. Now, look here. 719.8. Now this 8. 8 is greater than 5. So what you have to do? What I have told you? You have to put here 0 means you have to just forget this and you have to put 1 here. Add 1 here. So this will become 720. This is the rules for conversion. Now what you have to do? You have to complete this exercise yourself as I have shown you and I have discussed it very well. How to convert this? First you try. If you have any problem, class 5, I will send you some of the questions in the form of PDF. Don't worry, at least try. First try yourself, then I will send for the cross check. First you utilize your brain. Whatever I have told you, you understood or not, then I will come to know when you try and do it yourself. So what will be your homework for today? 1, 2, 3 we have completed. You have to start from question number 4. So question number 4, 5, 6, very easy. These all we have discussed. These also arrange in ascending order, very easy. Nearest tens, see nearest 10th, near 100, very easy. Nearest 100th place to the nearest meter, all these are very easy. So tomorrow we'll start addition and subtraction of decimal fraction and you have to complete this whole. Okay, whatever you can do in book, you can do in book. Like this, question number 7, that you can do in book. Question number 12, you can do it in book. Question number 13, 14 and this. Whatever it is possible to do it in book, you do in book. But rest all the questions, you have to do it in your maths copy. Take care and bye-bye.